Hey guys, Chris from Wex Photo Video here. Canon have just announced three new fixed lens video cameras. And in this video, we're going to be taking a very quick first look at those cameras and also really talking about where they fall into the sort of the fixed lens video camera offering from Canon. So these are the new cameras. We've got the XA40 and then we've got the XA55. Now, you'll notice that I am missing one camera. I did say there's three new cameras, and that's because there's the XA50 that goes in the middle that I'm missing. And the reason why I'm missing it is because it is exactly the same as the XA55. The only difference is that the XA55 has an SDI output. So, you know, there's no need for me to actually show you guys that. I'm sure you can imagine it without it. So anyway, yeah, I mean, over the past year or so, kind of have been refreshing their fixed lens video camera offering, updating all those cameras so that they are now capable of capturing in 4K. So before we move on and talk about these cameras, let's first sort of look at the whole sort of offering that they've got and where these cameras fit into it. So starting at the top, we've got the XF705, and that is Canon's flagship fixed lens camcorder. Now, it's got a 1-inch sensor at its heart, and that's going to give you all of the bells and whistles. That is their most professional, well-rounded fixed lens camera. And it'll allow you to record 4K up to 50 frames a second in glorious 10-bit 422. Now, if we go to the next level, one down from that, we have the XF405, which actually takes the smaller body that's similar to this of the XA55. That smaller body still got a 1-inch sensor, and it's still capable of recording 4K at 50 frames a second. However, instead of being able to record it in 10-bit, it is limited to 8-bit. We then drop down another level, and we get this, the XA50 or the XA55. Again, same sensor, same 1-inch sensor in there. However, this one is now limited to 4K 25 frames a second, again in 8-bit. If we go one down lower, which is basically brings us to this XA40, which will be Canon's sort of new entry level in the fixed lens camera range that they have. Now, this is the only camera in this range to not have a 1-inch sensor in there. Instead, it's a 1/2-inch sensor, so it's slightly smaller. And again, this can do 4K at 25 frames a second, again in 8-bit. So at the front of the XA55, we've got a 15x optical zoom lens, which at its widest is the equivalent to 25.5mm. Has a single control ring, and just next to it is a switch to flip the control to either focus or zoom, much like on the XF405. The camera also features Canon's market-leading dual-pixel autofocus with accurate and reliable face detection. And of course, that can easily be controlled by the flip-out touchscreen. And the power efficiency on the XA55 is also pretty impressive. Off the single battery that's supplied, you should be able to continuously record in 4K for around 3.5 hours. On both the XA55 and the XA40, you get 5-axis in-body stabilization, so that's going to be great for getting handheld shots. You've also got built-in ND filters, dual SD card slots, and a removable handle that houses the XLR connections and the audio controls. So you can slim down these cameras further if you want to. And there's also a pull-out EVF at the back. These cameras also have an infrared mode, ideal for when you want to shoot in little to no ambient light. And when shooting in full HD, both cameras oversample using a full 4K sensor to deliver a superior HD image. So the XA40 has a single control ring on that lens, much like the XA55 does. However, one difference is that the toggle switch for zoom and focus for that one ring isn't at the front. It's actually at the very back of the camera here. So if you're running and gunning, flicking between the two, might be a bit tricky because you have to have one hand at the back of the camera the whole time whilst you flip between the two. I'd probably suggest instead just using one of the zoom rockers for your zoom and then just keeping that lens control solely on focus if you need to do manual focusing. One other thing to note as well is that the XA40, now this is the only one that doesn't have a 1-inch sensor in the lineup, but it's also one of the only ones that doesn't have Canon's dual pixel autofocus in there, which of course is, you know, could be deemed as the market leading autofocus system. It does still have autofocus capabilities, it's just not the dual pixel autofocus in there. But, you know, with it being a smaller sensor, should in theory be easier to get your subject in focus, but also another perk of that is that it has a much more extended zoom range because of that crop factor. It's 20 times optical zoom on this, which I think is the equivalent to around 30mm to a 600mm lens in this little camera body here. So I hope you found this video useful. I know I find it quite hard to keep up with Canon's fixed lens offering. You know, I used to shoot on the XF305 back in the day when I was doing HD work, and then obviously all these other cameras have come out. The XF405 came out. I wasn't quite sure if that was meant to be a replacement for the XF305. Then the XF705 came out. So, you know, you got the XFs and the XA, and they all sort of intermingle. So I hope you found this video useful picturing, you know, where these products all sit in that lineup. So yeah, I mean, you're not gonna film your next period drama on these sort of cameras. You know, instead, these are sort of like workhorse cameras. These are the sort of cameras that I'd imagine, you know, journalists taking them out into war zones. They need something light, pretty robust. You know, everything that you need in there is in there, and they're just super quick and easy to get that shot. You know, and journalism, that's when it really matters, making sure that you capture the moment as it happens. So I hope you enjoyed this video. If you've got any questions, do pop them in the comments and I'll get back to you. If you enjoyed it, maybe hit the like and subscribe button. That would make my day. And I shall see you in the next video.